Oh no, sadness. Oh gosh. Are you okay? Did you survive the fall? That was horrible. My apologies. I just dropped the camera. I just dropped the iPod. Okay, so this is a sling, and it comes with two longer cords and another sling, or another light. It comes with three lights, but you can modify it really easy. They just have simple loops, right? And you can modify it to turn it into begleri. So it's a slyngeri, and it has LEDs, and you can turn them on, you can turn them off, you can make them blink. So they do chasing light patterns. Like that. See how they look when they're chasing light? They're pretty good weight. They're solid weight. They have shock absorbers, these bands that hold the battery in place. The battery is easy to change out. It's like one of those watch batteries. It's a round one. You can get these at Sling. They had a Kickstarter at one point, and now they think they make them now that you can buy them from their site. But this LED brightness is legit. It's like really bright. And you saw I put a video, a clip earlier. Pretty decent size. I want to say they're comparable to, they're like a teardrop shape. But let's see. Like for comparison, you might compare it to the size. That's the size that it is. Compared to a nunchuck. You got that little pointy part on top, but it's about the same width, same size from here to there. This is the part that sticks out a little bit. If you can sling these, then you can sling these pretty easy. And I don't want to say that they're brighter than anything I've ever slung, but they are. They are brighter than anything else that I've ever slung. And the lights last for, they auto turn off, I think in a minute. So after a minute they'll turn off. Or you can just press them and turn them off if you want to. But yeah, they're a decent weight. They're not too shabby, man. I haven't dropped them, I haven't really used them outside or anything, but they can take a beating, so I don't see anything wrong with them easily breaking. I don't see that happening. They come in double band, these are double band strings, and like I said, they're easy to remove, customize. That's one right there. So, so yeah, they're pretty easy to put together. And I've had sling for a while. I'm gonna release an unboxing of the sling. But I hadn't used it as a begleri. And so I'm doing that today. Way brighter than any other light up begleri that I've had. So check out Sling. The Sling is pretty cool. Now I'm going to show you, and I've probably already dropped some pictures of the voodoos. Voodoo. MFD monkey finger design made voodoos. Now these are stackable. Yeah, they're meant to be stacked. And you can stack them on each other. From what I understand, I think you can stack them on any other MFD beads. You don't have to put them on chain, but I put mine on chain. And they're held together with a jump ring on either side, a jump ring on the outside, jump ring on this side. That's where I connected my chain to the middle. And you can't see it, but in the very, very center of the bead running through it, I put a thin chain. I put change from play excess. And that's what's holding it together. What's up, Corey? So that's how I did that. This is a chain that I got, multicolored chain from Walmart. If you're a tough slinger, if you've got like really thick fingers or you just have a lot of strength when you play, these might not be durable for you, this chain. If you're looking into installing chain, this is a link. This is the only style of chain that I really like to sling with because it's pretty comparable to the width of a paracord. I set up two different ones. One with green, green, and red in the middle. This one green and red. And yeah, to me, I like chain. I'm not going to only sling chain because I like paracord too. But if I wanted to advise for someone to use an alternative cord option that they have, you know, that you can try, experiment with chain, why not? And if this is not very durable, you find, you go to Walmart, these only cost 98 cents, this chain. But your play style is kind of rough, I guess, then it's easily that you can pull these links apart, you know. So it depends on what your play style is. I haven't had it happen to me, but I like to say I play pretty damn rough, but you know, I am a girl, I have girl fingers, like long little slender fingers. I'm not gonna like pop them open. So you do have an option of using chain. You can always go and look for a chain that is similar to this link, but more durable. I advise going to play excess and getting the halo chain if you wanted to start using chain, because that's the most durable chain you're going to find. And it's not in color. I think they have only gold and silver. I'm not sure if they have rose gold available as a chain option color, but you know, they don't come in these kind of colors, but it's going to be more durable. So for those of you that are looking into getting into chain, I advise trying this first, but you're going to need that thin chain in the middle to go through your bore of your bead. You get that from play excess, or if you can find thinner chain, you know, that's what you're going to have to use, because there's no way that you can put the chain through the bore unless it's like a really, really, like a 550 ready. But even that way, I have my Herks, and I couldn't get the chain to go through it because it was just too thick. Now the only chain, or the only beads that this chain in particular goes through easily, are the chromentums. I didn't have any problems with those. So those ones do not need, in my experimentation of using chain, find that they are the only beads that do not require a thin chain to go into your bead. Let me show you. All you need are the jump rings that hold your chain in place. I'm sitting here. You're coming out now. No. No, I don't have my pliers with me right now. It's in there snug. But there's a jump ring in there. And that's the only thing that's holding this chain together, and goes through the bore really easy, this chain. This thickness of chain, anyway. It doesn't have a... You don't require to use a thinner chain, but the other beads do. Even this mini, 22 grams. See the jump ring inside? That's what's holding the chain in there. And I think I did an install showing these in particular on a previous live to show that the chain goes in real easy. Permentum has a really cool bore. It's wide enough for chain. So if you're thinking of chain, why not go for it? I'm doing it. I think it's cool. Oh, do you really? All right, Corey. Yeah, I like chain. I like it. And this thickness of links, for me, it's durable, but for me, it's also comfortable. If it were thinner, like, I'm not going to hate on change because I love change, but it's too thin for me as a full set for the center of a chain. I need something thicker. And Halo, which I have that Halo chain on another set. Excuse me. This is Halo chain right here. This is durable as fuck. Like, you're not gonna bend this unless you really, really try hard. Now I joined it with a little rinky tinky in the middle just to give it more length. So I took down some length I had of the thinner exchange at the ends. They were sticking out too long and it was bugging me. So I took those off and I extended it in the middle with a little splash of green color. But yeah, I recommend Halo chain if you want to get into the chain game. You want to get into the chain game. you gonna try it, Nick? But yeah, like, it's like I said, if you get a Walmart, you can get this pretty easy. I mean, this is cheap. So this is something that you might want to try before you invest in a really good chain, just to see if you like it. Because, you know, you may not like it, but I don't see why you wouldn't like it. I like it. It's not painful or anything. It's not torturous. You know, as long as you have this kind of a link, it feels like butter. Like, you can just, like, rub it on your fingers and you're not gonna get a burn or anything like that. Now, the thinner one, yeah, I'm not gonna lie. The thinner one is, for me, personally, I have, like, really soft fingers. So the thinner chain, I like to use it more for a joiner to going inside of the beads, but not for the middle of the play. That's where I like to use a thicker chain. Yeah, bite. I've never had that happen. Not even with a thin chain, I never had that happen. So it's like, if there's a lot of, you know, misconceptions of chain, a lot of people are, you know, just won't even try it because they're afraid of it or something, but... I mean, it's no more deadly than, let's say you're gonna play with a ballet song and cut yourself. If you're playing with a trainer, you're not gonna get hurt. You know, you might pinch yourself or something, but are you that afraid of pain? But for the chain game, there is no pain. The only downside is if you get a color, like I have these colors, the color will eventually rub off. It'll fade. And when that happens, the color will, you know, come off on your finger. You'll kind of get like residue. But, you know, that's the only thing that I can say that I've noticed using chain. Other than that, I can do pretty much all the tricks. I don't have any kind of limitations by using chain. Yeah, dude, like this one right here. Oh, you know what I did do? I have chain on my velo, and I put the change on it right off the bat, right? I put that change once I got it, and it was too thin for me, like I said. So this is another color that I got from Walmart, kind of like a bronzy matte color of gold. It's different to this one that I got also at Walmart. I don't know if you can tell the difference, you really can't tell, but one is matte and this one's shiny. So yeah, it looks, I think they look pretty cool. I think it looks really industrial, and if you're into like industrial look like this, I got these on my mini standards. If you want the industrial look and see how it flashes, how it catches the light, you know, you can't, that doesn't happen with just normal paracord chain. Give it a try, don't be shy. And like I said, these are my voodoos. I'm going to do some clips with them. I'm going to a super long can. And I have an unboxing that I plan to drop probably in the next couple of days. I just need to film some more stuff on it. And yeah. So I have these on set up as minis, my voodoos. I haven't stacked them yet, and the reason I haven't stacked them yet is because I'm having too much fun using them as minis. Right now I'm running monkey bars. I think I got brass in these, I got stainless steel in these, and that weighs it some. Then when I added the chain, I felt a little more weight was added to the set, which makes it more manageable for a mini set as opposed to using it as a full stack set that I haven't done yet. And I don't think I'm going to need to put weights in it once they're stacked, but by themselves alone without any kind of monkey bars in them, they're super light. So just so you know, I'm running weights in there, and the chain actually adds a little more weight to the set, because I had them on paracord initially. They played pretty good, but I would lose them every once in a while. Like there wasn't enough inertia to keep them because of their lightness. Even with monkey bars, it wasn't enough to keep them in steady play. So I found out that adding chain made a big difference to the weight of it. Interesting discoveries. Oh, thank you, Liz. Now you're making me hungry. I want to eat something now. I never do this angle. I felt like doing a different angle. You can kind of see what I'm doing a little easier. I'm closer to the camera at this angle, so I kind of felt like doing something different. I know you miss looking at me. Yeah, you miss my smile. But it's all right. You know what I look like. Let's see. I was doing a lot of weave type tricks earlier. involve a beat roll. Did you see that? If I can break that down for you, if you want to see what I'm doing right there. I'm going down this way. As it comes back around here, I'm letting it go through. So it's skipping this finger like that. Let me just see if I can do it again. Let's do it. Okay. So it's... Wait. This way. Okay, so I'm going this way, slipping this way, coming back around this way. Whenever I broke that down right. It's hard for me to do it in a static. Let me try to do it as slow as possible. Yeah? As slow as humanly possible. See what I'm doing right there? And then it drops to this. And then I bring it back around there, so it's... No, that's not right. There. This is a hard one to show. Okay, this way. This is where I'm getting confused. I don't know where the chain is or where the cord is going. Let me see. Okay, so it's like this. You see what I did? So here, skip the finger, and then it comes back around this way. Something like that. Hi, Toen. So that's a weave type trick that I've been working on. That's just your normal weave. A weave, it just goes like this. Kind of like, you think of like twirling, right? So it goes like that. Then when you want to do, let's say you want to do a zoot, that involves skipping your fingers. It skips a finger as you come back around this way. So this one is just a bead roll weave. I start with high grip. With a downward swing from high grip, I go to mid grip, then I go back to low grip, and that's where it ends up. So it's this way, yeah. Tell me if you can get that one. The only way I'm going to really be able to show it is if I slow it down. If I show it in slow-mo. Because this whole static stuff is for the birds. I can't seem to really get this motion down slowly to show you. To really break it down without it being a big jumbled mess. And then I forget where I'm coming from. And I don't want to teach you wrong, yeah? I don't want to. Deb, I saw you, Deb. I saw you were streaming, Deb. I saw you were streaming, Deb. Good job. Yes. I'm so proud of you. You streamed. My goodness. Now I know why it's been raining. The weather has predicted something crazy was going to happen, and it was Deb was going to stream live. Very cool stuff. I was slinging my my enans that are running your cotton cord that you sent me, your braided cord. It's the neutral color one. Good times, man. That's a great chord. I really love it. I don't see myself changing that chord for a very long time. I think it's just going to stay there. I have a thing where I'll change chords frequently if they need to be changed, but once I get them on this, on the chords that, you know, once I get my sets the way I want them on the chord I want, it takes me a long time before I need to change them again, because I don't really have that issue where my chords get all, like, you know, mucky or whatever. So, okay, I'm running out of time. I'm going to leave you now. I'll leave you with a freestyle with these. Oh, sadness. You know what I like about this slingery thing? Is that you can, it's got double chord or double band, so you can just slip your finger in here like this and then just do this number. That's what I did in the beginning of that one clip, and it looks all crazy, but that's all I'm doing. And that's kind of like a halo trick or something. I'm used to doing stuff like that with the ring, like have it free float as it spins. So that's kind of cool. That gives you something different you can do. I'll play these until they turn off, because they auto turn off. It's over, then the stream is over, and I'll let somebody else stream for a bit. Oh, really? I don't film enough between the legs stuff, and I do it a lot, so. Lights are still, oh, they turned off. So this is the slingeri. These are the voodoos. I will see you later. Thanks for watching.